Techniques of scientific management. Techniques of scientific management refers to techniques which the managers can use to achieve the principles of scientific management laid down by F.W. Taylor. To know about scientific management principles laid down by F.W. Taylor, please refer to the previous two videos. The first technique is the technique of time study. The technique of time study can be used by managers to ascertain the average time required to perform a particular task or job. Under time study, the job is divided into very, very small parts, and then the small parts are studied carefully by the managers to arrive at the standard time required to complete that particular job. Thus, time study can help managers to decide the time that an average worker will take to complete a particular task or job. This can help manager decide the remuneration of the workers, and also it can help the managers to plan out their activities properly. The next technique is the technique of motion study. Motion study involves a close watch about the body movements of the workers or employees. The managers can make use of this study to determine the movements of the workers or employees. This study can help managers find out the amount of time that is wasted in the movements of the workers during the production or any such activities. After doing motion study, the managers can plan their production in such a way or arrange their equipment in such a way that the minimum time is wasted on the movements of the workers during production. If done properly, this study can help managers to improve the productivity of the employees very drastically. The movement of workers from one place to another, or movement of materials from one place to another that requires labor, is an unproductive utilization of the time of workers. The same time can be utilized towards production of the goods and services by eliminating the time wasted on the movements of the employees. Thus, it is very important for managers to conduct the motion study and then plan their production activities or arrange their equipments in such a manner that minimum time of the employees or workers is wasted on movement from one place to another. Just to give you an example, let's consider this as a very small factory where the machinery is kept here, and because machinery is here, employees work in this around this area. Even though the workers work in this particular area, the raw materials are kept here, and in between the workers' workplace and the place where raw materials are kept, there is a washroom in between and there is a canteen. So in a layout like this, there will be a lot of time wastage because the employees have to go from here to here where the raw materials are kept. Instead, if the canteen is moved behind and the washroom is moved behind and the raw materials is kept near employees, then it can save a lot of time of the workers. This will reduce movement of workers from here to here, and this will result in significant time saving of the workers. Ideally, this raw materials has to be here, and the washroom and canteen should be in these two places. If there is raw materials here, employees need not go far. They will find the raw materials here itself, and it will result in tremendous increase in productivity of the employees.